If you are looking for an MMO, then maybe try Black Desert Online. BDO for short is one of the hit MMOs in the market and is one of the MMOs that I've played and enjoyed for almost 3 years. I started to play this game because I used to play World of Warcraft, and there are times when I get bored or I already finished the content that I want to do, so I switch to other MMO like BDO. I finally reached 730 gear score and I feel relieved and that I'm now kind of free from grinding. I don't know if I'm going to push my gear score, but for now I am satisfied with what I achieved. Is BDO for casual gamers? Yes. If you think you are a casual gamer, you can comfortably play this game without pressure of getting left behind. The game has been patched by the developers to make things like game mechanics to be casual friendly, and there are so many catch-up mechanics in the gearing system, unlike when I started playing this game 3 years ago. Now, let's be clear, there are players that are playing this game since the beginning, and there are also overgeared players playing this game. If you are thinking that there is no way you can catch up to them, then you are wrong. You can definitely catch up to them, but do not expect to catch up in 2 or 3 months. BDO is a very grindy game, just like any other MMO in the market. You can definitely catch up because the developers are really trying hard to make the game fit for casual gamers, but do bear in mind that it will probably take around 6 months to a year of playing, and it also depends on your gaming schedule, like the number of hours you play in a single day. There are videos out there speedrunning BDO to 700 gear score, which is considered as the start of endgame gear. BDO is considered by most players as a marathon and not a sprint, so take your time and enjoy the game. In the world of BDO, you can grind mobs or life skill in order to earn silver. Silver is the currency used in BDO even though gold exists, which is kind of weird. If you want to grind, you pick a grind spot, and there's a lot of grind spots to choose from scattered around the world, and earn silver and gear in the process. There are also world bosses around the world. You can hunt them in specific time and earn rewards. In my opinion, world boss doesn't give you great rewards and silver, but if there's a weekly boss event, then it is definitely worth it. You can also life skill. There's a lot of life skills you can choose from, like gathering, fishing, hunting, cooking, alchemy, processing, horse training, trading, farming, sailing, and bartering. You can earn silver doing all of this, but for me, in my opinion, I think grinding mobs is the best source of silver. Life skill for me is a good alternate activity when you are bored of grinding and have nothing better to do. BDO has the best combat system in the market as of the making of this video, and this is one of the reasons why I enjoy this game. I personally like the way you can chain your combos and even do infinite combo. The skills are easy to learn and it may sometimes take a while to get used to it, but when you finally learn it, it is really satisfying. There are also classes that are easy to play when it comes to combo or skill rotations, and there are also classes that causes arthritis. But do not worry, because you can go to the training area and learn how to play your class. There are also YouTube guides on how to play a specific class. Just like any other MMO, BDO also suffers from desync, stutters, and lag. But as of recently, Pearl Abyss has been hard at work on fixing these issues. I know that this doesn't sound good, but it is what it is. There are some custom settings that help with these issues that you can find on YouTube, and I can confirm that it actually works. Most of the stutter occurs in cities where there's a lot of players and NPCs. BDO cities are mostly filled with a lot of NPC, and I really like it because it doesn't feel like a lifeless place even though I don't interact to all of them. In most areas, like places where you are grinding, there's really not much of lag issues, but it also depends on your hardware, internet connection, and how far you are from the servers. Guild Siege, Node War, or Guild War also suffer from stutters because there's a lot of players in one specific area. BDO has one of the best graphics in the MMO genre, there's no doubt about that, and I really like how you can customize your character to the most minute detail. The customization on this game is so massive that it'll probably take you hours just customizing your character. You can also pick and download presets that are made and shared by other players. The attack animation and spell effects fits the class that you are playing, and it is also unique. The costume or outfits are also pretty good, and not only that, Pearl Abyss has been handing out costumes for free. Beauty also has its downside. If you go to YouTube and watch PvP videos about BDO, you can see that there are players that are playing on the lowest graphics settings because players are trying to achieve high FPS. Because for some reason, the DPS or damage on this game is tied to the FPS. If you have a decent computer, you really don't need to lower the settings and make your game look like RuneScape, but for some reason, they like that kind of settings. The system requirements for this game is really not that high, but because there are still unoptimized parts of the game, it causes stutters. But as I've said, it is fixable or it can be minimized. I just hope that Pearl Abyss update or fix all these issues in the future. There's a lot of classes to choose from in BDO. There are 27 classes and most of them are gender locked. But in my opinion, it doesn't really matter because there's a lot to choose from. I think it is gender locked because the dev doesn't have to make another set of animations for male and female characters. I also think that these classes are like main characters of a story, like for example, Dracania and Guardian. They look like the leaders of a specific faction and it would be weird if they get a male counterpart. Korean games has been known for having gender locked classes and I really don't have an issue with it as long as the attack animation and gameplay of a character feels good to play with and is unique. Each class in BDO is unique and for each class, there is a subclass, Succession and Awakening. You can choose one subclass at a time and you can also change it anytime you want. Each subclass has a unique playstyle. For example, a Succession Guardian uses an axe and shield, while an Awakening Guardian uses a Jordan, a two-handed weapon that looks like a halberd. When it comes to picking a class, pick a class that you think that is cool or whatever comes into your mind. For example, if you want a hot elf wielding a two-handed sword, then go for the Dark Knight. Dark Knight is the poster girl of Black Desert Online and she is the hottest character in the game. Also, don't worry about rerolling a character if you don't like it because there is a seasonal server and you can level up another character pretty fast. And there is also a tag system in the game where you can share your current gear to another character. Season server is a server for new players and new adventurers. It provides you with all the necessary information about BDO. It also provides you with a starter gear which you can upgrade and use. It also provides you with rewards that can help you progress in the game. A season server also gives you a lot of bonus XP to level up your character faster. Gearing in BDO takes a lot of time. Grinding mobs is probably the activity that you are mostly going to do in this game if you want to progress or improve your gear. In my case, I've been playing this game on and off and most of the time, I just log in and AFK fish. It's only recently that I grinded seriously because for some reason I started to enjoy it and also because there's no MMO that I like in the market. I play World of Warcraft and as of recently, there's no content that I'm really interested in, so I started playing BDO. To be honest, I like the gearing system in WoW even though they made some stupid changes in the game that nobody asked for. The one thing that I like about BDO's gearing system is that your gear is relevant no matter what you do. What this means is that if you quit for 1 year and decide to play again, your gear is still usable and you can still use it on any content in the game unlike WoW where every season you need to change or find another upgrade for your gear again. The one thing I like in WoW when it comes to acquiring gear is that it is much better and fun compared to BDO where you can only grind in circles or farm leaves like a life skiller. in order to gain silver. In WoW, you can do raids, mythic dungeons, and world boss. And these gears can be upgraded and can be used on any content. But the sad thing is that when the season ends, you need to regrind everything all over again. The one activity I really like in World of Warcraft is Mythic plus Dungeons, and I have to say it is the best way to grind gear and at the same time push the dungeon difficulty as far as you can. In BDO, there's nothing like that. All we can do is grind in circles, and I know BDO has a dungeon, but in my experience it was so terrible that I said to myself that I'm not going back. When I tried the Atoraxian dungeon, it took me and my group almost 4 hours because everyone was trying to get knowledge in every corner of the dungeon, and we were figuring out how to do the puzzles. It was not fun for me because we were not doing a dungeon, but we were like exploring the dungeon in a weird way. I thought that we are going in the dungeon to cleave monsters, but instead we ended up doing some puzzles and jumping over obstacles trying to find knowledge, and it was a big disappointment. When we started to fight the monsters in the dungeon, it was fun, but it was underwhelming, but that's just me. Also, the reward is bad, let's be real. You can earn more silver grinding 1 hour in a decent grind spot compared to doing 1 Atoraxian run even if you speedrun the dungeon. Let me also add that there's really not a lot of build choices in BDO. There are only 3 choices: DR, Evasion, and Full DR. DR stands for Damage Reduction. It means that any damage you take is reduced, simple as that. Most tanky characters like Guardian like to run DR builds. Evasion is dodge most of the attack and get hit once in a while. Evasion is pretty good, but you are kind of squishy because if you get hit, then you are going to take a lot of damage. Full DR builds are almost unkillable characters, but you also don't deal damage. You rely on your teammates to deal damage. Full DR is considered by most players as a meme build, but for me, I kind of like it, and I'll probably make one in the future. Gear enhancing is the way we improve the gears we have in BDO, and this is the most disliked gear progression. And this is one of the reasons why a lot of players doesn't want or at least try to play BDO. To cut it short and to make your life easier, you don't need to enhance your entire gear. You just need to enhance some of it, and it is really easy. After that, you can save silver and buy almost every endgame items in the central market. You only need to enhance your season gears, which is very easy. Seasonal gear enhancing is like an introduction on how to enhance gear, and after that, you buy everything in the central market up to a certain point. If you want to get 700 gear score, you can definitely buy everything in the central market. You can even get to 730 gear score just buying items in the central market. BDO is also known for its PvP, and most of the players that play this game like to PvP. There's Node War, Arena of Solaire, Red Battlefield, Arena of Arsha, War of the Roses, Guild League, and last but not the least, World PvP. There's also Cap PvP like Node War Tier 1 and Tier 2. Cap PvP is a PvP where all the gear has a limit or a cap to even the playing field for all players. There's also Battle Arena, a place where you can practice your combo and fight 1v1. World PvP is also a thing in BDO. This means that if you are out in the world doing something, you can get ganked out of nowhere. There is also a karma system to prevent red players from killing you over and over again. Karma points is a number, and the moment you reach 0 karma and you die, there's a chance that you will downgrade your gear, and that is a well-deserved punishment. If you are grinding in the world, you don't really need to worry about getting PK'd because there's a system called Marnie's Realm private server. Marnie's Realm is like a private room just for you, separated from the world, and in there you can grind peacefully for 1 hour. Also, for the new players, you don't need to worry about PK while grinding if you are in a season server. Honestly, I suck at PvP, that is why I prefer Apex Legends when I want to fight other players. BDO's PvP is so fast I can't even react, and there are characters that are blinking all over the place. There are also classes that are so efficient in PvP like the Dracania, but it's all good and I understand that because it's all part of the game. I'm a PvE guy and when it comes to MMOs, I prefer the PvE aspect of the game. I know I'm 730 gear score and I didn't even bother to learn how to PvP. Some of you might say that it's a waste of gear, but for me, I had fun gearing my character for PvE. For me, this is what I like to do and I enjoy my time playing the game, but that doesn't mean that I already closed the door for PvP. Maybe someday I will try to learn how to PvP. This is the part where I'm just going to be blunt to all of you. The story in BDO is dull and boring as hell and the quests are soulless. When I was doing my main story questline for the first time, I lost interest after a few hours. I was not invested and I really didn't care about what is going on with this world. There's nothing that made me intrigued in the story and the world of BDO. The only thing that captivated me into playing this game is how cool the characters' attack animation and the combat system that they have and not the story. This is not like World of Warcraft storytelling or Final Fantasy XIV. There is actually a story in BDO, but I only discovered it through YouTube. Some guy in YouTube pieced together the story of BDO and I understood what the hell is happening in this world. It was pretty interesting and I liked it, but for some reason the game wasn't able to properly convey its own story. For the quests, it's just the regular boring talk to NPC A and then talk to NPC B or sometimes it's going to be a fetch quest. There are also some quests that will ask you to eliminate X amounts of monster in a specific area. My advice is to save or find a lot of movies or podcasts or any videos that you can find on YouTube or Netflix and play whatever you have in your second monitor or in your phone if you want to get through the story or quests in BDO, especially when you get to the Magnus story and if you are going to do your adventure logs. The Magnus and the adventure logs, if you plan on doing it, will probably take you a month to finish it all. The Magnus questline provides you access to teleport around the world and access to your storage around the world. The adventure logs is a side quest that provides you with AP, DP, HP, and stamina and all other sorts of bonuses that will help you with your adventures in BDO. The Magnus alone, if I can remember correctly, took me around 12 hours and for the adventure logs took me forever that I don't even remember. I hate doing the adventure logs to be honest and I am so glad that it was over, but it is worth doing it. Some of you might like it, but not for me. I will not do it again and I hope they do not introduce something like that again in the future. The most common question or the most concerning question about BDO is BDO pay to win? Yes, it is pay to win. Sad to say, but it is pay to win. Now, this doesn't necessarily mean that you can buy an overpowered item in the cash shop and become the next ruthless king of a specific city who's going to decide the fate of every player that goes in and out of the city, because this is what most people think when it comes to pay to win. Pay to win has evolved into something else. Pay to win means that you can buy things in the cash shop to further yourself ahead from everyone, save time, and increase loot. So a good example of this are tents, pets, weights, maids, inventory slots, artisan's memory, and specific costumes like the processing, cooking, and alchemy costumes. There are inconvenient aspects in the game and the only way to relieve it is for you to buy stuff in the cash shop. Pay for convenience is like the most common issue in most MMOs nowadays. Most MMOs love to create artificial problems and then sell the solution in the cash shop. Let me give you an example as to why the pay to win tent is important. The pay to win tent gives you access to Villa buff, which is a lot better than the regular buff that you can get on the regular tent. The pay-to-win tent can repair your items anywhere in the world, especially when you are grinding saving time. Another example are the pets. If you can get all your pets to tier 4, you can loot faster, making your grind much more efficient, especially in the early game. I will talk more about the pets in the future because this is one of the most annoying aspects of the game. Another example are the processing, cooking, and alchemy costumes, which is a lot faster and it saves you more time when you are doing life skills. I bought the Traveler to Explorer DLC and Explorer to Conqueror DLC because it was on sale, and I think it was worth it. To be fair, you can play BDO without buying anything from the cash shop. I myself haven't bought the pay to win tent, which is considered one of the best cash items in the game. You can still play the game and progress normally, but do not expect to catch up right away from people paying real money. If you don't want to pay for these items, you really don't need to. There are catch-up items in the game like free pets that you can obtain from quests, but it takes time to get all of them. My advice is don't buy it if you want it and pay for it if you really need it. Wants and needs are two different things. To sum up, BDO is a great game, give it a try. There's a lot of things in the game that might interest you and there's a lot of content to do. For me, the one thing that really made me enjoy this game is the combat. It is simply very satisfying cleaving monsters. Now, let's be clear that BDO is not a perfect game, but in my opinion, it is polished but it has its flaws. As of now, the game developers are doing a lot of changes and patches that make the game better, which is much appreciated. Every couple of months, there's a new content and new class, and there are also a lot of changes in the game which improves the quality of life. Now, I know that it is a hard pill to swallow that this game has a pay-to-win cash shop. There's no MMO in the market that doesn't have any pay to win or cash up right now, and that's just how things are nowadays. Just be smart with how you spend your hard-earned money. BDO is a game that will provide you with countless of hours playing this game, so take it slow and have a good time. I had so much fun with this game and I really enjoyed it. There are aspects of the game that I like and there are also aspects of it that I didn't enjoy. I know I probably miss certain things in the game, but for now, this is all I can come up with. I will make another video talking about other aspects about BDO, but that will be for another time. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.